Okay, so next we want to discuss about finding the inverse by using elementary row operation, which is called as arrow. Okay, so now let's go let me introduce a little bit about this. So consider we have a matrix A. Okay, matrix A is a 3x3 matrix. Okay, so these are the three things that you can do with elementary row operation. Okay, number one, you can change any two row in the matrix. Okay, so let's say the matrix A, you have 1 2 3 negative 1 2 0 3 1 1. Okay, then if you want to change or you want to swap the place of the row in the matrix, you write it down like this. Okay, R, which represent the row R1, so row number 1, you swap with row number 3. Okay, so you put a small star right here, which indicates the formation of new row number 3. Okay, okay, as you can see, the 3 1 1, which was initially in the third row, now switch place with the first row. So the first row will go at the position of the third row. So 3 1 1 negative 1 2 0 1 2. Okay, so this is how you mention that you want to swap the position of the row in the operation of elementary row operation. Okay, then second, you multiply all the elements of a row by a scalar. Okay, let's say if you want to multiply the second row of the matrix, which was -1 2 0, and you want to multiply it with 2. So you write it down like this: 2 multiply with the second row and small arrow, and it will form a new row number 2, which you represent it with the symbol of a small star like this. Okay, then you can see your new matrix with a row that was multiplied with -2. So you can see here -2 4 and 0. Okay, then the third operation, multiply all the elements of a row by a scalar and add the product to another row. Okay, so for this kind of thing, if you want to change, okay, let's see if you your purpose, if you is that you want to change the third row. Okay, as you can see the thing here, R3 with a small star is the one that you want to have. Okay, R3. Okay, so you want to edit the R3, so you put the R3 in the middle. Okay, you put the R3 in the middle because that is the one that you want to change, not R1 that you want to change. So that's why in the operations here, -3 R1 plus R3 arrow R3 star. Okay, R3 star to means is the thing that you want to do. Okay, then if that is the thing, is that is the place where you want to make the change to occur, so you put the R3 in the middle. Okay, so the operation here is they take -3 multiply with R1, so the row number 1, we have 1 2 and 3 right here, and then multiply it by -3 plus R3 to become the new row for R3. As you can see, the new R3 is now right here, 0, negative 5 and negative 8, which was made after the operation of this one. Okay, and you can see, you can notice that R1 doesn't even change because the operation mentioned that the star, the small star, is placed with the R3. So there is, so R3 is the one that you want to change, not R1. So that's why R1 just stay the same. Okay, these are the three operations that we will use to do elementary row operation. Okay, never mind if you cannot understand this thing. Okay, so later on in the explanation, I will explain more about this. Okay, so next thing is to find the inverse by using elementary row operation. Okay, so let's say we have a matrix A. Okay, for, look here at example 6.18. We have matrix A, which is a 3 by 3 matrix. Find A inverse by using elementary row operation. Okay, but first let's go to page 160 right here. To find the inverse of a matrix A, start by writing the matrix in the form of A and I. I indicates the identity of the matrix and change it by elementary row operation. Okay, so firstly, we have to write down like this. We create another region in the matrix separated by the line and create a identity matrix for the matrix A. Okay, for example, if we have here a matrix, a 3 by 3 matrix, 2, negative 1, 1, 1, negative 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, and negative 1. So, if you want to find the identity, so, sorry, if you want to find the inverse, so you create another side of the matrix with its identity. Okay, this is the identity matrix for a 3 by 3 matrix. So, the diagonal is 1, then the others, the entries other than the diagonal will be a 0. Okay, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so that is the first step. Okay, make sure you write down the new matrix in this form. Okay, then you have to follow this procedure. Okay, follow this procedure. Step number 1, obtain a number 1 in the first position of the leading diagonal. Okay, where is the leading diagonal? This right here, 1. Sorry, initially it will be here, 2. Okay, obtain number 1 in the first position of the leading diagonal. Okay, how can you change this number 2 into number 1? Because the procedure wants you to change it into the number 1. Okay, so the operation here mentioned they change the position of R1 and R2. Why? Why do they swap the position of R1 and R2? Because R2 has number 1 right here, right? Okay, R2 has number 1 right here. So, they want to swap places so that the first leading diagonal will be number 1, as which follows the first step. Okay. Okay, so now let's look at an example how to find the inverse of matrix A by using elementary row operation. Okay, the first thing that you need to do is to make an adjustment to a matrix A. Okay, you will have a right side and the left side. On the left side of the matrix, you just copy down the matrix A, the elements of matrix A. 1, negative 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, negative 1. Okay, then you separate the left side and the right side with this line. Okay, and then on the right side, you write down the identity for matrix A. So, since matrix A is a 3 by 3 matrix, so then its identity will be like this. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so that is the identity for matrix A. Okay, so this is the first step in doing elementary row operation to find the inverse. Okay, then the second thing that you have to do is follow the procedure. Okay, you follow the procedure written here, just the same from your reference book. Okay, step number 1, obtain a 1 in the first position on the leading diagonal. Okay, so how can you obtain first step? Obtain the number 1 in the first leading diagonal. Okay, you can refer to the operations in the page 160 that I have mentioned before, the 3 operation, whether you want to swap the position of the row, or you want to multiply it by a scalar, or you want to multiply with a scalar and do operation of addition. So for this one, since we can see the second row have number 1 at the first column. So we can just use the operation of row swap. Okay, where the actual name, okay, interchange by any two rows. Okay, so you just interchange row number 2, interchange with row number 1 to create new row number 1. So it will be 1, negative 1, negative 1, 2, negative 1, 1, 2, negative 2, negative 1. So 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, as you can see, whatever you do on the left side of the matrix, okay, the right side will follow. Okay, okay, as so your objective here, if you want to change the left side of the matrix to become its identity, okay, you want to change left side to become 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1, so whatever you do on the left side, it will also happen on the right side of the matrix. So when you have done, finally you have found the identity on the left side. So the matrix on the right side is the inverse that you are looking for. Okay, just let's do this until finish. Okay, then we follow the second step. Since we have done the first step, obtain zeros under 1 in the first column. Okay, now we want to find, make sure that this number becomes 0. Okay, how can we do that? We refer back to the 3 operations in the page 160. Okay, so how can we change number 2 into 0? Is by multiplying negative 2 with row number 1 plus row number 2 to become row number 2. Okay, we multiply the first row and we plus with the second row to become the new second row. Okay, the first and the third row, you just copy it down, because whatever, because your operations mentioned here doesn't involve any changes on the first and the second and the third row. So 1, negative 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so you have negative 2 multiplied by 1, it becomes negative 2 plus 2. Now we have 0 right here. So negative 2 multiplied negative 1 becomes 2. 2 minus 1, we have 1. So negative 2 multiply negative 1, it becomes 2 plus 1, then it becomes 3. So negative 2 multiply 0. Okay, negative 2 multiply 0 becomes 0 plus 1, then becomes 1. Negative 2 plus 1 plus multiply 1 plus 0, then it become negative 2. Negative 2 multiply 0 plus 0, so it be 0. Okay, so now we have done the first step, the second step. Okay, now look at the third step. Obtain a 1 in the second position of the leading diagonal. Oh, sorry, since we have not yet done the first, the second step, obtain zeros under 1 in the first column. Okay, which means it wants us to change these two also to become a 0. Okay, change these two to become a 0. So how can we do that? Okay, is by taking negative 2, we multiply with R1 plus R3 to become new row of R3. Alright. So we doesn't even make any change on the first and the second row, so we just copy it down. 1 0 1 3 0 1 0 1 negative 2 0. Okay, so we are doing changes on the third row. So negative 2 multiply with R1, so we have negative 2 plus 2 it become 0. So negative 2 multiplied with negative 1 become positive 2 plus negative 2, then it become 0. Then negative 2 multiplied with negative 1 becomes positive 2 plus negative 1, then we have 1 right here. And then negative 2 multiply 0 plus 0 becomes 0. Negative 2 multiply 1. Negative 2 plus 0 become negative 2. So negative 2 multiply 0 plus 1. And then we have number 1. Okay, so now, only now we have done the first, the second step. Okay, we have done the second step, which to obtain the zeros and the one in the first column. So now our first column, so we can see here our column number 1, under the diagonal 1, these are already in 0. Okay, now we have done the first and the second step. Now what we need to do is go to the third step. Obtain number 1 in the second position of the leading diagonal. Okay, where is the second position of the leading diagonal? Is this number 1. So since it's already in number 1, so we have done the third step. Okay, if it's not in number 1, so you have to do any of the three operations in page 160 to change it to become number 1. But make sure, in order to do that, you didn't revert back the number of 0 right here. You didn't change back the number of 0 right here to become any number other than 0. Because it must stay in the 0 position. Okay, it must stay with number of 0 until the end of this process. Okay, then we go to the step number 4. Obtain a 0 under 1 in the second column. Okay. 0 under 1 in the second column is this. So, since it's already in 0, so we have done our fourth step. Okay. Then, step number 5, obtain a 1 in the third position of the leading diagonal. Okay. The third position of the leading diagonal, which one is it? Is this one, number 1. So since this also already in number 1, so we have done our fifth step. Okay. So since we have completely done this first lower triangle, okay, 1 1 1 0 0 0, so what's left is to obtain zeros. Okay, is to obtain zeros above all of the number 1. So means we have to change this negative 1, negative 1 and 3 into 0 by using also the three operations mentioned before. Okay, so what we need to do is we want to change this number 1. Let's go for this negative 1 first. Okay, so in order to do that, we take row number 2 plus row number 1 becomes new row number 1. Okay, so it will be just write down the row that you didn't make any change. 1, negative 2, 0, 0, negative 2, 1. Okay. Okay. So, the first row, now we have R1 plus R2. So, 0 plus 1 is 1. Okay, 0 plus 1 is 1. Then, 1 plus negative 1 becomes 0. So, 3 plus negative 1, it becomes 2. 1 plus 0. Okay, 1 plus 0. It becomes 1, negative 1, negative 2, plus 1, it becomes negative 1, and here will be 0. Okay, so now we have done for that number 1. So now let's move to the other entries, which is number 2. So we have to change that to become a 0. Okay, we have to change that to become a 0. Okay, in order to change that number 2 become a 0, so we take negative 2, multiply with row number 3 plus row number 1 and becomes new row number 1. Okay, becomes new row number 1. Okay, so negative 2 and negative 2 multiply with 0. Okay, negative 2 multiply with 0 plus 1, so it become 1. So negative 2 multiply with 0 plus 0, so it become 0. So negative 2 plus 1 become negative 2 plus 2, then it become 0. Okay, so negative 2 multiply 0 plus 1 stay as 1. So negative 2 multiply negative 2 become positive 4, minus 1 becomes 3. So negative 2 multiply 1 become negative 2 plus 0, it be negative 2. Okay, the only things left for us in this calculation is to change this number 3, number 3, and make it change it into a 0 by multiplying negative 3 with the third row plus the R2 to become the new R2. Okay, 1 0 0 0 0 1 1 3 negative 2 0 negative 2 0. Okay, so negative 3 multiply 0. So negative 3 multiply 0 plus 0 is 0. So negative 3 plus multiply 0 plus 1 is stay as 1. So negative 3 multiply 1 plus 3, it will be 0. So negative 3 multiply 0 plus 1 stay as 1. So negative 3 multiply negative 2, so it become a positive 6, minus 2 become 4. So negative 3 multiply 1 plus 0, it will be negative 3. Okay, so we have completely changed the left side of our matrix to become the identity. You can see 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 on the left side. So this is the identity. Okay, then what does the right side indicate? So the right side now indicates the inverse of matrix A. So we can write it down as inverse of matrix A equal to 1, 3, negative 2, 1, 4, negative 3, 0, negative 2, 0. Okay, so this is the method of using elementary row operation to find the inverse of a matrix. So it's a quite long process and bit complicated and risky also. Okay, a lot of things involve, a lot of operation, multiplication and addition right here, and a few procedure that you have to follow the step, make sure that you follow the step correctly. Okay, alright. Okay, now let's move on to another example, also called as a matrix A but different elements, not the same as before. Okay, so now let's use elementary row operation to find the inverse of this matrix. But firstly, you have to remember the operations involved, the elementary row operation, and the steps involved in doing elementary row operation. Okay, so firstly, we write it down like this. We create two sides of the matrix, 2, 0, 2, 3, 1, 3, 1, 0, 2. We write down the identity on the right side. Okay, so now we can proceed with the operations to change the left side into the identity of matrix A. Okay, firstly, remember the first step is to change the first leading diagonal into number 1, And we have another number 1 at the third row. So what we can do is swap third row to become the row number 1. So now our matrix become 1 0 2 3 1 3 2 0 2 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 0. All right. Now what we need to do is to change the number in the first column into 0. Okay, so in order to do this, we take negative 3 multiply with R1 plus row number 2 to becomes new row number 2. Okay. Okay, so the rows that are not involved with any changes is the row number 1 and the row number 3. Okay, so we take negative 3 multiply by 1 become negative 3 plus 3, so it be 0. So negative 3 multiply 0 plus 1 becomes number 1, and then negative 3 multiply 2, so negative 6 plus 3, we have another negative 3 right here. Okay, so on the right side, negative 3 multiply 0 plus 0 is 0. So negative 3 multiply 0 plus 1 is 1. So negative 3 plus multiply 1 plus 0 is negative 3. Okay, so next we have to change this number 2 to become a 0. So in order to do that, we take negative 2 multiply row number 1 plus row number 3 becomes new row number 3. Okay, so 1, 0, 2, 0, 1, negative 3, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, negative 3. Okay, negative 2 from the row number 1. So negative 2 multiply 1, negative 2 plus 2 becomes 0. So negative 2, sorry, I should write it down right here. So negative 2 plus multiply 1 plus 2 becomes 0. So negative 2 multiply 0 plus 0 is 0. Okay. And then negative 2 multiply 2. So we have negative 4 plus 2. We have negative 2 right here. Okay. Then negative 2 multiply 0 plus 1 stay as 1. So negative 2 multiply 0 plus 0 is 0. So negative 2 plus multiply 1 plus 0 is negative 2. Okay, so now the number, the elements are the number 0 in the first column has completely changed into 0. Okay, now we have to move to the second column, second leading diagonal, which is number 1. We have to change this one into number 1. And since this is already number 1, so we don't have to bother with any operations. Then we have to change this number under number 1 into 0. And it's already in 0. Then what next to do is to change this negative 2, which is the next leading diagonal. Okay, next leading diagonal is this negative 2, and we have to change it into number 1. So how to do that is to multiply the third row with a scalar. So we have third row, we multiply it with negative 1 over 2 to becomes new row number 3. Okay, 1, 0, 2, 0, 1, negative 3, 0, 0, 1. Okay, so Negative 1 over 2 multiplied by 0 is 0. Negative 1 over 2 multiplied by 0 is also 0. Negative 1 over 2 multiply negative 2, then it will become number 1. So on the right side, it will be negative 1 over 2, 0, and it will be number 1. Okay, so now we have come to the process where we have to change the number above the diagonal into number 1. Okay, so let's now firstly, we change this number 3 into 0. Oh, sorry. I think I mentioned change it into number 1, right? Sorry. Actually, we have to change it into 0. Okay, so in order to change this into 0, we take number 3 multiply row number 3 plus the row number 2 to becomes new row number 2. So, 1, 0, 2, 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 1, negative 1 over 2, 0, 1. Okay. So, 3 multiplied with 0 plus 0 is still 0. 3 multiplied by 0 plus 1 still as 1. So, 3 multiplied by 1 minus negative 3, so it becomes 0. So, 3 multiplied by negative 1 over 2 plus 0. So, it becomes negative 3 over 2. So, here will be 3 stay as 1. And right here will be number 0. Because 3 multiplied by 1 minus 3 is equal to 0. Okay, there is only one last procedure to make, is to change this number 2 into 0. So, we multiply negative 2 with row number 3. Plus row number 1 becomes new row number 1. Okay. Okay, so negative 2 multiply 0. So, plus 1 is stay as 1, negative 2 multiply 0, plus 0 is stay as 0. So, negative 2 multiply 1 plus 2 will be 0. So, negative 2 multiply negative 1 over 2 plus 0, so it will be a positive 1. So, here will be 0 and negative 2 multiply 1 plus 1, we have negative 1. Okay, so now we have identity completely changed the left side of our matrix to become a identity matrix. Now our right side shows the inverse of our matrix. So inverse of matrix A is equal to 1, 0, negative 1, negative 3 over 2, 1, 0, negative 1 over 2, 0, 1. Okay, so that is how you use elementary row operation. Okay, so if you want to try, you want to test yourself, you can also use cofactor method and find the inverse of the matrix A and check whether it gives you the same answer or not.